On March 4th, just hours after filing an on-the-ground assessment of the first few weeks of the Russian invasion of Ukraine, Kyiv-based breaking defense contributor Reuben Johnson disappeared. While driving to the train station, he says he was ambushed and his car riddled with bullets. Now, miraculously, he survived, but he says he was robbed and captured by Russian soldiers and detained at gunpoint for two full weeks. Reuben Johnson joins us now to tell his story. First, Reuben, you must feel so lucky to be alive. Tell us what happened when you were driving to the train station near Kyiv.
Well, thank you for having me, first of all, and thank you for staying on this very important story. What was happening was we were driving to a train station to try to get an evacuation train that would have taken us to the west of Ukraine and eventually to Poland. And the road that we were told was open was blocked. When we tried to go around a roadblock, there was no one present. But as soon as we tried to skirt the roadblock, out of nowhere appeared Russian soldiers, and they just began shooting. They never asked us to stop. They never gave a warning. It was just, you know, shooting at anything that moves.
Well, specifically, what did you learn when you were in captivity? I mean, you were there for days upon days. And specifically, I'm wondering if the Russian soldiers' conversations gave you a glimpse of what was happening with the invasion from their perspective.
Well, they're like everybody else. They, in Russia, they were cut off from almost any news sources of any kind. So they wouldn't know from the media what was happening, but there was plenty of news trickling in from elsewhere. And they, first of all, were mystified why they were still in Ukraine, because they were told they'd be in Ukraine for 4 or 5 days and the war would be over. And here they were weeks later, still there. And then next to us was a medical triage unit where you could hear casualties coming in and lots of screaming, moaning, soldiers in pain, and then occasionally even a soldier being wrapped up in a body bag. You could hear all of this. And this was all, well, I should say, not great for morale and caused Russian soldiers, at least some that I spoke to wonder exactly how long this could last.
That may be indefinitely. Can you explain how and when you were released from captivity?
Well, we had been told a couple of times that, oh, we're organizing your release. We can't release you because there's shelling going on everywhere and you wouldn't live, you know, you wouldn't get 50 meters without being killed. And suddenly one day we were told we were being released and we were driven through Chernobyl all the way out to the border near Belarus and then dumped in the middle of nowhere. And we were told to start walking. Belarus is that way. And that's all it was. It was simply no notification of where we were going. We weren't given our passports back until we were dumped by the side of the road.
Well, we're grateful that you got out with your life. That's more than many. But you've said, though, that the U.S. weapons are making a big difference. You've seen evidence of that. But the problem is that the supply is running low. Tell us more about that insight.
Well, it's not just U.S. weapons, but it's the weapons that have been coming from everywhere, and especially the in-law, which is a weapon provided by the U.K., jointly developed by the U.K. and Sweden. And simply what everyone is saying, the same thing now, that we've given away all that we can give away without depleting the stocks that we need to have for our own military, should our own military need to engage somewhere in the world. So after 2 months of fighting in Ukraine, there's no more surplus left. It leaves you with the impression that there's not enough equipment being produced on a regular basis to sustain anything like a long-term military operation. And the timelines to replace this stuff are just unbelievable. I'm told it will take 2 years to replace the javelins that have been given to Ukraine. That's a very, very long time when you're in the middle of a war.
Well, it certainly is, but we are grateful that you are back to the United States in safety. Reuben Johnson, thanks for joining us on New Day.
Thank you.